On my staff attendance sheet that I did a previous video on, and I have put a link on this video to the previous one, but I have designed a form for you to enter the leave for any time during the year by entering it on a user form. So I'll show you how it's done. And so I click on enter leave. A user form comes up and your employees are listed here, and you basically just enter the employee that you'd like to use. And so I'm going to click in employee, and I'll select four. You select from the months, and I'm going to select February, and they would like February 5th through the 9th. And now I'm going to click enter leave. Now, so we're going to clear the form and we're going to close it. And then we are going to scroll across until we get to February. And there you see that the leave is already entered in here. Now you could enter for any, you wouldn't have to scroll for each month to try to find which days they were leaving. You could just put it in on the user form. So let me show you how I did it. So I have my user form, the name. Okay, for the month, it's a combo box, and how I entered the, so let's click on the combo box. And if you go down to row source, down here it says months. And so what I have done is I have put on my user sheet, on sheet number 2, I have done the drag from January to December, and I've named this rain month. And it automatically knows to put in the months into our user form so that you can just drop down and get them. And all of these are just text boxes. And then we have enter leave is where my code is. Clear form just clears it out and closes it. It's just unload me. Okay, so let's double click on the leave. And so now let's describe what I've done here. I've defined name as a string, RNG as a range, row number, move month as an integer, last start or leave start and leave end, difference, leave next as integer. Okay, so text box, if you have nothing in there, it's going to say enter name. Now, name equals trim, so if you put spaces in there, it's going to forget that. And then it's going to search for those in column A, and that's where we have the names of our employees there. And then if it doesn't find anything, it says name not found. And then if it finds it, it records the row number that the range or that the name was found on. And so then we have our combo box. Now, I have only done it for January, February, and March, but basically you could do it by just adding the number of days. So for if you were going to put in April, you would do this again, but instead of 63 days, you would add 30 days onto here, so it would be 93 days. So you would move the month to start at at 93. Now, if nothing is selected for the months, then it's going to say no month selected. And the L start, which is the date you put in, is you're trimming this again to make sure you haven't got any spaces or anything there, plus the move month. And the move month is what you have. You're moving it for February, you're moving it 34 spaces. So you've got move month. And then what it's done is it's... you have the L start and the L end defined now, and in the sheets with the row number, which where it's found the employee name, the L start and the value equals V, and sheets one cells row number LN, which we've defined up there, the value equals V. Now, the difference between L end and L start, if the difference is greater than 1, L next equals L start, and do while L next is less than L end. So sheets one cells row number L next equals value equals V, and then it's increasing L next to L next plus 1, If lnext equals ln, then go to end e, and I've put end e under the end loop. And so here's the end if for this little one. This is the loop for the do while. End if and end e. To create the button on my user form, enter leaves. So show form is what's producing this. To clear it out, which is my clear button, it is, I've just made them all nothing. To close it, it's simply unload me. So that's how you create a user form to enter leave for your staff attendance sheet. Please subscribe.